Hello, my friends. Welcome to another mini message. Today, Sunday, we're going to be talking about Mark 1st, from 14 to 15, Jesus begin his ministry.
Later on, after John was arrested, Jesus went into Galilee, where he preached God's good news. The time promised by God has come at last, he announced. The kingdom of God is near. Repent of your sins and believe the good news.
Amen, amen. You know, he preached the good news, right? That's for us, right? The Great Commission, right? All of us, we need to be like Jesus and, you know, follow his steps and preach the good news. And he says, the time has come, right? And we live in the times, you know? And he says, the kingdom of heaven is near, right? So, in that time, the kingdom of heaven was our Lord Jesus Christ, right? Was near, has come, right? Because God was working among us in earth, right? Through our Lord Jesus Christ. And for us, you know, when we open our Bibles and we read the Word of God, we're seeing the kingdom of heaven that is close to us because we see God himself, because the Word of God is God, as we learn, right? And God lives in ourselves through his Holy Spirit. Jesus said, the Father and I, we're going to live in you. God, one God, living in us through his Holy Spirit, right? So we have the kingdom of heaven in us because we're the temple of the Holy Spirit, the temple of God, right? And he said, repent. So we need to come boldly to God and repent of our sins, repent of these carnal ways that we're following, the way the world wants us to follow, right? We come to the Word of God, we know the will of the Father, and we repent because we want to do the will of the Father, right? We want to be like the way he wants us to be, the way Jesus showed us to be, right? Because we need to be like Jesus, right? And he says, and believe. We need to believe, right? In the gospel, believe in what Jesus is telling us. You know, come to me. Get close to me and I will get close to you. I will put my spirit, I will live in you, I will empower you to walk the way. Because it's not easy, but with God, with Jesus in our hearts, it is easy, right? And we believe in everything he says, that he's living. He's in heaven. He's in the right hand of the Father, but he's going to come back for us, right? He said, there is many mansions in my Father's house. I'm going and making prepare for you, a place for you prepare. In the same way I'm leaving, I'm coming back for you. So we believe. We need to believe in everything Jesus is telling us. We need to believe in the Word of God. You want to ask something?
Mm-hmm. Well, I just love the last sentence. Repent of your sins and believe the good news. It's really depressing to realize that you're a sinner mm-hmm. and all the mess that we are in. Mm-hmm. And then, but not recognize what Jesus has done for us. That's a very mm-hmm. hopeless place to be. But Jesus says, repent of your sins and believe the good news. Believe what he's done for us. Mm-hmm. And then that way we can, you know, carry out the Great Commission and we can live a life that is a disciple, becoming a disciple of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. And so, yeah, there's a lot of hope there. There's no hope in just knowing that you're a sinner without mm-hmm. understanding the gospel of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. So as we go, we need to share with everyone that we can the good news. And I would say it's also impossible to really catch hold of the good news unless you understand that you're a sinner. Mm-hmm. If you don't think you're a sinner, then there's really nothing to... It doesn't have anything to do with you, you know? Yeah. So we're all sinners. We all need a Savior. We need to repent and give all of that mess to Jesus because he died on the cross for us, rose 3 days later, and now we have a sure future and a hope in him.
Amen. God bless you, my friends. Bye.
Bye.